This is Winners 8.1. Transform into Winners 7, ha! Gotcha! With just only one executable file, you can get from this to this. But before that, let's check out the installation. Here is a version Windows 8.1 installation with the start screen and all Windows 8.1 stuff. Running the setup, you can see it's using the Windows 7 style setup. Agreeing the agreement, you can choose a branding between Windows 7 Professional, Windows 7 Ultimate, or Windows 8 Professional, which I choose. The ribbon style between Windows 8 Developer Preview 1 or the Windows 7 1, which I choose. You can pick one of the three, in my case it's just two, option to bring back the Windows 7 start menu, either by status back, which is paid, open shell, or X7 for Windows 8, it's just only for Windows 8.0. To play safe, I use open shell. The Aero glass, which you can select one of the two options, and also the option to keep automatic and chocolate coloring, or either to remove it. This last page confirms the choice and makes sure what changes you want for the OS, such as games, gadgets, task manager, and many others. The first phase, preparing for the transformation, the second phase, installing all programs, the third phase, registry tweaks, and fourth phase, file and icon replacements. Rebooting the Windows, the boot screen is replaced with the Windows text as what the consumer preview did. The logon sound is present, the branding is present also down there, as well as the default profile picture. Nice.
Nice.
The desktop is looking good with the Windows 7 Aero Windows style present. But let's change that to the default Windows 7 theme and let's begin our investigation. The start menu is a close replica to that of Windows 7, even though no pin apps are present at the time. The start menu folders are also arranged like what Windows 7 does. Opening WinVer, and you can see the branding has changed to Windows 8 Professional, although the version still reported as NT 6.3 boot 9600. Getting started application is recreated to look as close as possible to Windows 7 1, despite no animation. The Aero glass in here is addictive. As you can see, the change of glass texture is depending on the window location. Windows Explorer is patched with all new Explorer to resemble the layout of Windows 7. System icons is also apparently changed in some places. Windows 7 pre-installed themes is present here, as well as the 11 regional themes. Windows Classic is also in here, although it's far away from the original Windows Classic scheme and look. Windows 7 sound schemes are also added in here, rather than just a ghost folder in Windows 8.1 onwards. User account control panel is in here, you can partially customize it, although you still need PC settings to modify further. Charms bar is kept in here with the icon changed to Windows Developer Preview 1. The functionality is not broken here despite Windows 8.1's end of support. With Charms bar also, you can access Windows 8.1's start menu from there. As you can see, some metro icons are replaced to earlier versions such as PC settings, photos, and OneDrive. Sample media such as sample music. Sample pictures. And sample video are included in here. System applications are either kept such as Notepad, modified such as WordPad and Paint, or replaced with the Windows 7 ones such as Calculator and Task Manager. Games Explorer along with Windows 7 games is also included in here. For example, I played Spider Solitaire. But don't worry, you still get the Metro applications available. Old tab interface is also changed to Windows 7 look, as well as the gadget in here is usable. And many other things. And many other things that are well made thanks to I'm Sword King and Dominic Hayes, the Linux Dude, amongst many other people. They are really cool people. Some bugs and quirks that I found in here is that the title text is still in the center, for some reason, and the login screen is not fully Windows 7 look because no one has ported the Windows 7 logon UI.exe into Windows 8. Aside that, even Windows 8.1 is unsupported by Microsoft, if you want to experience Windows 7 and its glory without leaving your Windows 8.1 copy abandoned, this is for you, GigaChad. Once again, thank you for I'm So King, Dominic Hayes, the Linux Jude, and many people who made this transformation. Thank you for my Patreon supporter for making this video possible, and I'll see you in the next video of Everything Windows. See you next time. Goodbye.